1927. Jack Youngwood for the Newark Ledger.
Stacey Jane Harlan for the New York Graphic.
On the strange case of the Radium Girls.
Who claimed they were poisoned at the hands of their employer.
And now seek their day in court.
$250,000!
That's the price tag on their suffering.
$250,000?
Ask me, it's all a sham.
What are you talking about? Those girls are very sick.
Sick of working, sure.
Doctors say the Radium Girls have only a year left to live.
Only 1 year to live and 250 grand to spend. What would you do with that kind of money?
What would you do to ease your last suffering days on Earth? What would you do with $250,000?
I'd buy a wardrobe like Irene Castle's.
I'd give it all to charity.
Then I'd travel around the world, first class with all my friends.
I'd play the stock market.
I'd buy my wife a fur coat and a diamond the size of a hamper.
I'd use it to pay for my medical bills. And to pay off the second mortgage on our house, the one my father took out to pay for my last operation.
Pretty Grace Fryer sits at home,
suffering bravely through this entire ordeal,
struggling valiantly to keep up her flagging spirit
for the sake of her family and her friends.
It hurts to smile, but I try to smile. I know if I don't smile, I'll go crazy.
Tell us, Miss Fryer,
try not to think about it.
But it must get to you somehow.
Knowing what you've been through.
And the company's getting caught up for labor.
All I have to say about it is...
No comment! Don't you just want to punch somebody?
Oh, no. That won't do no good. I'd rather just think about how it's gonna be when justice prevails. Then maybe I could do something nice for the folks. Send them on a trip. They never did have no honeymoon.
What a fine example of womanhood. We can only aspire to bear our cross in life as nobly as this young girl.
This kind of histrionics?
I had nothing to do with that, Mr. Markley.
I've been in this game a long time, Mr. Barry. When I see a story like this move over the wires, I'm not so naive as to believe that a plaintiff's attorney has nothing to do with it.
What's your proposal, Mr. Markley?
$1,500 to each girl.
$1,500?
That's not even a year's wages.
We think it's very generous, considering your piece won't survive the statute of limitations.
This is a case in equity, sir. The Chancery Court will come to a different conclusion.
The Chancery Court can't rewrite the law, and the law is clear. 2 years from the date of injury, your clients are out of time.
2 years from the date the cause of injury is discovered.
Very creative, Mr. Barry. Very clever. I must admire your imagination. But you've a long way to go before you convince the judge.
And in the meantime, Mr. Markley, the press will continue to take a great interest in this story. And in the company's complete indifference to its workers.
No doubt that'll prove to be good press for the Consumers League. And you accuse us of exploiting these girls.
You're the one hiding behind the statute of limitations.
Hiding, Miss Wiley?
You know very well the law never anticipated a situation like this. These girls were dying before anyone knew the cause.
Before anyone knew? Does that include the U.S. Radio Corporation, Miss Wiley? When should I say, if this case goes to trial, I only hope that's your opening argument, Mr. Barry. You will be our defense. See you at the hearing.
The arrogance of that man.
Tell me again the purpose of these articles, Miss Wiley.
Public sympathy, Mr. Barry. Send it on the form.
You're antagonizing the company.
Your strategy's working.
And what about these girls? How does it help them to read in a dozen different newspapers that they have so little time to live?
Mr. Barry, surely you can see. The U.S. Radium Corporation cares nothing about the girls it is poisoning, but the average housewife in Orange cares very deeply. So do millions of other women across the country. These women shop. They buy watches. Mr. Markley can be as smug as he likes, but the Consumers League campaign can only have one outcome, and he knows it. That's why he's here today.
I only hope you're right, Miss Wiley.
Public sympathy, Mr. Barry. Wait a second.
do you deserve a few fleeting hours of happiness? Sincerely, your admirer, Leonard F. Watkins. P.S. Closes my picture.
Look at this, Catherine. This man actually sent a picture. You all right, Catherine?
Bleeding again.
Oh, shall I get a nurse?
No, it did this before. I'll stop.
Maybe we should go.
No, don't go.
Don't you need to sleep?
Who can sleep? I never sleep.
Well, you'll sleep tomorrow.
Yeah, might not wake up.
Of course you'll wake up.
Not if it don't go well. Sometimes you don't come out of it so good. My mother's cousin, she went into the hospital for her appendix and she never came home again.
Well, you just can't think that way, that's all. Look at this nail, Catherine. Miss Wiley said folks will be on our side, and she sure was right. Here's one from California.
What if we don't win?
Of course we'll win.
But what if we don't? My father will lose his house. We'll be on the street. You'll be on the streets, too. Your father must owe thousands, and you and Tom, you won't ever get married. How can you stand it, Craig?
Catherine, please.
How can Tom stand it? Don't you ever wonder, Grace? I don't ever hear him complain.
Catherine, as soon as the judge hears our testimony, he's gonna rule for us. All they gotta do is take one look at us. It'll be over in a day.
You think so?
Sure. When they see what kind of shape we're in, it'd be awful hard to ignore, don't you think?
Well, that'll be something then, won't it? To see the look on Mr. Reeder's face when we get on the stand.
Now, you want to read some more letters?
Didn't have no vanilla, so I got some chocolate.
Took you long enough.
Don't get on me. I had six people stopping on the way over here. All of them reporters, and all of them asking after you.
Waiting for me to die.
No one's waiting for you to die.
It's true. One of them called my mother, asking if I had died. She said no. They sounded disappointed.
Try to eat a little of this, you'll feel better.
Eat it or I'll come out of picture!
For the love of Mike, what are you doing?
Eat pictures for the graphics exclusive on the girls.
Exclusive? What are you talking about?
$5,000. That's money. What do you say, Grace? That sounds good to you. Think you could use $5,000?
I don't understand.
Perhaps you're familiar with Bernard McFadden.
Who? Pat Faithfuller?
Herbalist, Mr. Kreider. Herbalist? Bernard McFadden's patented herbal therapy is just the thing to get these girls back on their feet for the graphical paper. All we ask is the exclusive rights to their story from here on out. See for yourself.
You want to pay us to go see Bernard McFadden?
Easy money, huh?
Let me see.
You're serious, Grace.
Graphics always does business on the up and up.
I don't know.
Grace, what? Your father own house?
I don't know exactly.
That last hospital bill? That was a couple hundred at least.
At least.
Maybe we should think about this.
And all we do is talk to this herbalist fella?
Well, of course we'll have to get our money's worth. The regular series of features with pictures following the course of the treatment for illness, recovery, or otherwise, depending on how it goes.
And then you print whatever you want?
Maybe we add some color. Everybody adds color.
Don't sound so bad.
Maybe we should talk to Miss Wiley about it.
Miss Wiley? What's it to her? You're the ones with the bills to pay.
Wouldn't it be right to do something like this without talking to Miss Wiley?
You're a big girl, Grace. Can't you make your own decisions?
Of course I can make my own decisions.
You'd take it if it came from the company.
The company owes us a lot more than that.
If you ever see it.
Grace, maybe we should do it.
It just
talk to the reporters anyhow. They might get something out of it.
He's right, you know. Why give your story away when people are crazy to read it? Believe me, you girls could cash in big. The day we ran the feature on you, bang, sold out every copy at every newsstand. Everybody can sympathize with the plight of some poor, sick girl facing certain death with no hope of fulfillment in motherhood.
I'd like you to go now.
Why?
My friend is tired. She needs her rest.
Please think about it.
Sure. Think it over. I understand. You're worried about what people will say. But hey, you gotta think of your own interests here. There's no reason you shouldn't get something out of all of this. Look out for number one. That's the way. Everyone else is out to get what they can. For sure, why sit back and keep your nose clean when everyone else is up to their elbows in it?
An excellent idea.
I don't know. Perhaps we shouldn't be so quick to dismiss Neff's proposal.
me.
We're in a very bad situation here, Mr. Reader.
That's true. Mr. Lee says you're having trouble getting girls to work.
Yes, and we've lost some contracts because of it.
And it's going to get worse.
And those papers are full of stories about those girls.
Making them out to be saints.
Then what defense can we put out?
Except to say we'll try a case in court.
And in court of public opinions, we've already lost.
Perhaps we should reconsider. It certainly wouldn't hurt to have testimony from the dentist who treated those girls.
And that could be very helpful. We should retain him.
Retain him as what? An extortionist?
As an expert.
Like Dr. Flint.
Dr. Flint is a highly respected professor at Columbia University. Nat is a neighborhood dentist.
But Dr. Flint treated some of those girls.
He didn't treat them. He merely consulted with them.
He dispensed medical advice.
It wasn't medical advice. It was an expert's opinion, a scientific opinion.
How about this? We retain Nat, but we don't put him on stand. Just we can keep him from testifying to the woman.
That's the most important thing.
Yes, I agree. That's the most important thing.
Well, would you agree to something like this, Mr. Reader?
Mr. Reader.
Mr. Reader.
Edward, we can't possibly do this. We can't get into bed with a man like Nat.
Arthur's right. We don't want to do business with Nat.
He could hurt us. We have to take steps.
Nat has already given us everything we need. New evidence, gentlemen. This is grounds for postponement.
Harvard study.
Concealing the ill effects of its product.
Read all about it in the Ledger.
Read it.
point not to these days.
If only other people would do the same. Mrs. Mitchell, from across the street.